Good morning, class. In the last previous lecture, we have learned about the particular solution, types of solution, in which we have learned about the colloidal and suspension as well as solution, then about the difference between the colloidal suspension as well as the true solution based on the property, like unki size kaisi hai, wo filtered honge ki nahi, then they are homogeneous or heterogeneous, then they show Stignard effect or not, they show Brownian movement or not. Okay? Then what about the particular stability of that particular solution, was stable or unstable hai. So that what we have learned in the form of differences in the last particular module. Now today we just going to learn about the concentration of solution. Solution hai, toh kaisa hoga? Agar aapne water liya hai, water mein when you are just going to add salt, aapko neembu pani banana hai. So you can just add the proper amount of salt. If you are adding more amount of salt, what happens? That lemon water is not going to be there helpful in drinking because of the more amount of salt. So what is it? That is nothing but it is the concentration of solution. Okay? What is it? The concentration of solution. That means that we have solute dala, jiski wajah se uska jo bhi particular nature usme thoda bahut change hua. Wo lemon solution now it becomes more salty. So cannot able to drink it. So this is known as concentration of solution. And how it is going to express that concentration by two way, by volume percentage and mass by mass percentage. Then we are just going to learn about the numericals which are related with that particular methods. And lastly, we learn about the effect of evaporation on that solubility. So here we are just going to learn about the definition of the solution, concentration of solution. It is nothing but the amount of solute present in the given amount of the solvent or solution. It is expressed by two methods, mass by mass method, that means you can write W by W percentage method, and volume by V by V percentage method. Suppose when we talked about 10%, 10% of glucose, glucose is solid. Okay. So we will take the mass. That means we are taking 10 gram of glucose. कोई भी solution हमेशा होता है 100%. या तो हम लिखेंगे 100 gram. That means what 10% glucose है, तो 10 gram glucose बाकी के 90, that means 90 gram of water में dissolved है. So 10% of glucose के लिए हम लिख सकते हैं कि 10 gram of glucose, glucose is nothing but the sugar. Dissolved in 90 gram of water. So it is going to be calculated by mass, by mass. Why mass? Because glucose is solid, we are just measuring in the form of mass gram. So 10% is nothing but 10 gram of glucose dissolved in 90 gram of water. So we learned the examples today that related with mass by mass percentage as well as the volume by volume percentage. So what is concentration? It is nothing but how much amount of solute you have dissolving solute. Solute that means the lesser quantity component of solution, and solvent is the larger quantity component of the solution. So we learn about the examples today. Here when we talked about mass by mass percentage, when we talked about, so the number of parts by mass of one of the component, that may be solvent per 100 ppm, and is nothing but parts per million. It is known as parts per million. So how are you going to calculate it? The mass percentage of binary solution, that means it is made up of two components, solute plus solvent. So how are you going to WA, that means we have two components, component A and component B. Suppose component A is solute and component B is solvent. So we are taking mass of component, that means solute bhi ho sakta hai, solvent bhi ho sakta hai, upon total mass, that means what, the mass of solute plus mass of solvent into 100. You can write in this method. Component ki jagah pe aap likh sakte hai solute, as well as you can write mass of solvent upon total mass of solution solution into hardware. So this is the general formula for finding out the mass percentage. Okay, percentage of the solution by which method? Mass by mass percent. Okay, so mass percent of component A, that means mass percent of solute, and mass percent of component B, that means mass of the solvent. So you can write by this method also, instead of W you can write that mass of the solute upon total mass of the solution, by which you can write WA plus WB. Okay, so this is the particular one formula. Second, volume by volume. Volume is then measured in ml or liter or deciliter picture. So next is, how are you going to find out the volume by volume percentage? So it is also the number of parts by volume of the any other component like solute and solvent by their parts per million solution. That is 100 parts per million. Now that is my volume percent of A. A is solute, suppose, and B is solvent. So we have volume of solute, so the particular solute upon total volume of solution into 100. So this is all about the general formula. Now we learn about the numericals. Only I have just wrote the particular. यहाँ पे लिखा हुआ है कि a solution has been prepared by dissolving 5 gram of urea into 95 gram of water. Now which is going to be dissolved? Urea. So we can write that urea is solute and water is solvent. Okay. So we have to find out the mass percent of urea. That means what we have to find out? Mass percent of urea solute. That is equal to what? Mass of solute upon total mass of solution into 100. Now what is the mass of solute? It means that is 5. So what we are writing is 5 gram of urea upon 5 plus 95 gram of solution into 100. So what we have? 5 upon 100 into 100. So we have 5% of, we have 5% of urea by mass. Got it? So what we have? Little nothing but mass. 5% of urea by mass. Urea is solute because it is very less amount. Water is in more amount, so it is known as solvent. So how we can find out the total mass? Total mass is going to be find out by mass of solute plus mass of solvent. So what is the mass of solute? It is 5 gram of urea plus 95 gram of water. So that is 100 gram of solution. You can write that 100 gram of solution. So what we have? 100, that is going to be cut. So we are getting 5% of urea. That is about the first numerical for you. Now second what we have to find out is, calculate the mass of canned sugar and water required to prepare 250 gram of 25%. So children, here mass percent of solute is given. Mass percent of solute, and solute is nothing but it is canned sugar. So that is how much? It is 25%. Now total mass is given. Total mass of solution is also given. It is equal to 250. So what we have to find out? The mass of canned sugar. That means what we have to find out is mass of solute. We have to find out mass of solute, or you can write canned sugar is what we have to find out. So what we are going to do is, we are writing the formula for that. Mass percent of canned sugar, that is equal to mass of solute upon total mass of solution. Into hydrogen. So what we are writing is, what is the mass of solute? So that what we have to find out. So what we are writing is, that is equal to, suppose x then. So what we are writing is x upon total mass, that is 250 gram into hydrogen. Okay? And then after what we are going to do is again, next what is, we are having the mass percentage, that is 25%, that is equal to x gram upon 250 into 100. So what we are getting is x is equal to, that is going to be cross multiplied, 25 upon 25 into upon 10. So 5 is a, so what we have is 25 is a 125 divided by 2. So that is around 6 to the 12, 62.5. So that is all about cost, that is about the graph. Or you can write that 625 divided by 10, so that is 62.5 gram of calcium dissolved in water. One. So that is what about why that we are going to find out the mass percentage we are having total mass, so we have not find out the mass of solid. So that is related examples. You can also have idea that how to know the particular numericals. How we can know? Again we are just going to write that what we have written, that mass percent of tensuber, that is equal to mass of tensuber, that what we have to find out, upon total mass of solution, total mass of solution into 100. Now what is the mass percent? It is 25%. Suppose this is x gram, total mass is 250 gram into 100. So that is going to be cancelled out. So what we have, x is equal to 25 into 25 upon 10. 25 square is always 625 upon 10. So we are having the answer 62.5 gram of cane sugar dissolving water. Dissolving water. So that is one example. Two examples we will learn about the mass by mass percentage. Now we learn about the volume by volume percentage. So instead of mass, what we are writing is volume. So we know what we have, that the solution contains 5 ml milliliter of alcohol mixed with 75 ml of water. So calculate the concentration of solution in terms of volume by volume percentage. So here volume percent is equal to volume of the alcohol, because alcohol is the solute, upon total volume of solution, 100. So volume percent of alcohol which we have to find is, so volume percent of alcohol is, what is the volume of alcohol? 5 milliliter upon 5 plus 75 ml into 100. It is going to be cancelled out. So what we have, 5 into 100 upon 80 we have. So we can write that 50 divided by 8. So 8, when we talked about 8 folds are 8, 6 are 48. That is about 6.2%. So that is about volume by volume percentage. How we can find out volume of the component that may be solute or solvent? Here what we have, alcohol. So we can write the volume of alcohol upon total volume of solution. Total volume of solution can be क्या करेंगे, सॉल्यूट और सॉल्वेंट दोनों का जो भी सॉल्यूशन पर्टिकुलर अमाउंट है उसको हम ऐडअप करेंगे। तो हमारे पास है 5 ml ऑफ अल्कोहल एंड 75 ml ऑफ वाटर। सो दोनों को मिला के हो गया 75 + 80 ml ऑफ टोटल वॉल्यूम ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन इनटू 100, बिकॉज यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट द परसेंटेज। सो वी हैव 5 × 100 अपॉन 80, सो व्हाट इज द आंसर इज 6.2% ऑफ अल्कोहल बाय द वॉल्यूम। ओके, सो देयर इज व्हाट अबाउट द न्यूमेरिकल रिलेटेड विद वॉल्यूम बाय वॉल्यूम। You can practice which is given in your textbook also, and that is also going to be practiced by us in the next module. Now we will learn about the next solubility. Solubility that means कि अगर हमने sugar को water में dissolve किया है तो उसके ऊपर temperature का कोई effect होगा कि नहीं। तो मैंने सबसे पहले बोला था beaker में आप sugar को add करते जाओ तो एक level ऐसा आता है जब sugar dissolve होना बंद हो जाती है, that is known as saturation level of the sugar, water. Water now not allow the sugar particles to dissolve in due to the space. So, we will say whenever the no more solute is dissolved in solvent, that solution is known as which type of solution? Saturated. How it becomes unsaturated? Applying a heat. Saturated, unsaturated में कब convert होगा? जब saturated solution को heat करोगे, तब. That means what? कि sugar solution में sugar dissolved होना बंद हो गई है. उसे आप जैसे ही दोगे फिर से वो क्या होगा, डिजोल्व होना स्टार्ट होगा। सो सॉल्युबिलिटी ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन इंक्रीज विद इंक्रीजिंग द टेंपरेचर। सो व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द एंडोथर्मिक प्रोसेस, एंडोथर्मिक प्रोसेस क्या है, जिसमें हीट एब्जॉर्ब होती है, वो बाहर सराउंडिंग में से हीट लेता है, तो उसके लिए हम बोल सकते हैं कि उस वो टाइम पे जो भी पर्टिकुलर सॉल्यूशन है उसकी सॉल्युबिलिटी इंक्रीज होगी जैसे जैसे टेम्परेचर इंक्रीज होगा। बट अगर एक्सोथर्मिक प्रोसेस है, वो पहले से हीट रिलीज कर रहा है, तो उसकी सॉल्युबिलिटी है। सॉल्युबिलिटी इज नथिंग बट व्हाट द प्रॉपर्टी इन विच द सॉल्यूट इज गोइंग टू बी एडेड इन द सॉल्वेंट। तो अब एक्सोथर्मिक की बात करते हैं तो उसमें क्या होता है कि इज गोइंग टू बी रिलीज द हीट, वो पहले से हीट रिलीज कर रहा है, तो उसकी जो सॉल्युबिलिटी है आप टेम्परेचर पर बढ़ाओगे तो सॉल्युबिलिटी क्या होती जाएगी, डिक्रीज होती जाएगी, क्योंकि उसके पास जो हीट थी वो अब कहाँ जा रही है, बाहर जा रही है। So that is what we have learned about today. In the next module, we'll learn practice more numericals related with the concentration of solution and the remaining part, which is about the physical change as well as chemical change. And along with that, we have to also learn about the techniques which are used to separate out solute and solvent. So this is going to be learned in the next module. So what we have learned today about the concentration of solution, we have done about the solubility, we have just done the numericals related with it by mass percentage by cubic meters, mass by mass and volume by volume. So in the next lecture we are going to learn, discuss about the particular remaining, that is physical change and chemical change, that what we have learned in 8th class also, or 7th class we have learned about this, and we are just going to learn about the separation techniques which are used for separating solute and solvent. Stay happy, stay healthy at home.